طيب بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين السلام ورحمة الله okay brothers we start inshallah continue our class which is about explanation for كتاب رياض الصالحين and we as I said before we follow the explanation of Shaykh Muhammad Salih bin Asameen, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy upon him. And we finished chapter 1, which is about sincerity and correcting the intention in ibadat. And today we'll move to the second chapter, which is chapter number 2, which is about repentance. Repentance. طيب. What does it mean, repentance? Tawbah. At-tawbah. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, it's mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That he accepts the repentance of anyone who commit any sin. All sins could be forgiven except one sin. If the person die with it, then there is no hope that he will get into paradise. But as long as he is living, he still have a chance to repent even if he was mushrik, even if he was disbeliever. And this is, yani, subhanallah, mercy from Allah Azza wa Jal, that sometimes he gives some people long life, you know, 60, 70, you know, hope for them that they will repent, they return to Allah Azza wa Jal. Scholars said it is necessary to repent from every sin. We don't need to hear this because the Quran has already commanded us. وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ And repent to Allah, all of you, all believers, that you may get success. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ طيب, if the offense, now here we just, you know, giving some, like it's introduction about the repentance. Because some people, they said, should I ask or make repentance for every sin? And what are the conditions of repentance? And this is why we need to talk about this introduction. So he said, if the offense involves the rights of Allah, not a human, then there are three conditions to be met in order that repentance be accepted by Allah. Which means that, you know, any wrong that we do, it could be classified in two categories. Some which is against ourselves, which refers to our duties toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and some which involve other parties, other people. Okay, so we have two categories. Sins committed relate to ourselves, which means to talk about something that we do of committing sin, which should not do it, like, you know, committing sins or unpermissible acts, doing something which is unlawful in any way, either by saying, by action, by believing. This we call it, it's a sin which is related to the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What are the rights of Allah azza wa jal? The right that we worship him alone and never worship anybody else. The right that we should do our prayers on time, that we should do our duties, right? And should stay away from whatever he subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibited for us. Clear? So these are, now, nobody else involved in this. This is between Allah azza wa jal and me. Therefore, how should I repent in this situation? If a person, for example, he says something which is unlawful, something that may get him out of the religion. He did something which is forbidden, like drinking alcohol or eating pork or having any sin which is considered as disobedience to Allah Azza wa Jal. So what should we do? Here, we have three conditions, three steps. First of all, to give up right away. To give up from doing continue this sin right away. This is first. Second, we should regret what we did. That means we have sorrow in our heart. طيب, because the Prophet ﷺ said, "An-nadamu tawba." An-nadamu tawba. When you regret, this is by itself, it's considered as what? As repentance. طيب, طيب. Third, should determine, not to do it again. تمام. طيب. Some ulama add something which is not conditions, but as support for you in your repentance. Like what they said, and he should leave the place or the people that they remind him to commit this sin. Bad company. You know, a person that he knows that when he goes with so and so, they will take him to bar. They will take him, you know, to disco. They will take him to, they said, okay, let's attend party. And in their party, you know, they will drink. And this, mashallah, he said, no, I'm a Muslim. I can go with you, but I'm not a drink. طيب, the first time, second time, in this environment, and then he may try it. Okay, إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ, as some people they say. Allah is forgiver, ya Shaykh. Allah is merciful. Subhanallah. And the shaitan, this is step by step. وَلَا تَتَبِعُوا خُطْوَةِ الشَّيْطَانِ. Don't follow the step of the shaitan. It doesn't come at once. Step by step. So in this case, the person, my dear brothers, should stay away from bad company. يعني subhanAllah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warned us against going with bad company. Why? Because they get man to the hell. May Allah Azza wa Jal protect. طيب, any repentance, parent to meet any condition would not be sound. So these are very, very important three things. But if the sin includes somebody else, like stealing from somebody, cheating somebody, taking the rights of somebody, testify or give testimony, and you know that what you say is wrong, and this person could be convicted because of your testimony, these rights of others. Therefore, it's not enough to say, oh, Allah, forgive me, and the guy, the poor guy in the prison there, because of your testimony, what should you do? You should go and correct, and you say that what I say was not correct. Okay? And save that person because of your testimony. But they will put me in prison. It's better for you to be in prison, not him. Right or not? You see? And this is very important. So, the right of others. It's very important to respect the right of other people. طيب? So then we start with the Shaykh started with some of the ayat here and some of the hadith. Let's go and what the Shaykh or some of the ayat said, and then we'll come to the translation of these verses. طيب. قال سبحانه وتعالى وتوبوا إلى الله جميعا أيها المؤمنون لعلكم تفلحون. This is the ayat that I just mentioned there. توبوا, this is a command. فعل أمر. توبوا, not توب. توبوا, that means all of you. توبوا, هذا أمر للجمع. For plural. This, Allah عز وجل address whom? All the believers. توبوا and repent to Allah. And then said, جميعا, all of you. أيها المؤمنون. You, the believers. لعلكم تفلحون, that you may be successful. Look, first call you in plural, then address you, all believers. Said, how come we repent? We are believers, we repent. Yes, some people they said, but I didn't do anything wrong. No, brothers, in fact, in every time you don't know what your eyes see, right or not. You don't know what your ears hear. Even you didn't intend to do it. But you don't know, right or not. You don't know what the word that you say, if it's be in the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal or not. So the Muslim always what? Seek forgiveness. This is why, استغفار. Oh Allah forgive me, oh Allah forgive me. Are we better than the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم؟ ها؟ سبحان الله. The messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, Allah عز وجل forgave him for him all his sins. And the Sahaba, they said, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, in every time when he said, we count for him sometimes, 70 times he say, oh Allah forgive me. سبحان الله. And he's the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. طيب, so this is, قال عز وجل وأن استغفروا ربكم ثم توبوا إليه. طيب, and then استغفروا, that means seek forgiveness, ربكم your Lord, ثم توبوا إليه, then repent to him. So here استغفار and توبة. What's the difference between استغفار and توبة؟ استغفار to ask forgiveness, oh Allah forgive me. نعم, هذا استغفار. توبة that you do it with the three conditions that we mentioned before. طيب, يا أيها الذين آمنوا توبوا إلى الله توبة نصوح. Oh you who believe, توبوا, repent to Allah توبة نصوح, sincere repentance, real repentance from your heart. طيب, قال المؤلف رحمه الله باب التوبة. التوبة in the Arabic meaning, linguistic meaning, he said from the verb تابة. تابة three letter, تابة, تابة, and all the Arabic verbs, its origin in the past tense. طيب, تابة, what does it mean تابة? He repented, he repented. The meaning تاب in Arabic means to come back. إذا رجع تاب يتوب, that means he came back. So this is the meaning of توبة شرعا. Right. Now we talk about the linguistic meaning. Now let's take the Islamic terms as Islamic terms. What does it mean in the religious meaning? It said وشرعا الرجوع من معصية الله تعالى إلى معصيته إلى طاعته. To come back, to return from this disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to his obedience. So this is the meaning of what? Of tawbah. طيب, the Shaykh said, and the most important and the greatest one is the repentance from disbelief to belief. This is considered as what? Repentance. Like in a person who was not a Muslim, we say he convert. He in fact he repented. هو تاب إلى الله, because he was committing shirk, he was committing kufr, and then he returned to Allah Azza wa Jal with what? With iman, with belief in him. So this is repentance. طيب. طيب. So the Shaykh said here, this is the biggest, the greatest one. And then it's come the second level, to repent from all major sins. All major sins. And we'll talk inshallah about what does it mean major sins. Because there's many different views for the ulama. The ulama said, some of them, whatever there is warning in the Quran that this who do this will be cast in the hell, that means this is a major sin. Others said, the major sin depends on the consistency. That means if the person persisting, that means always, continuous, this will be considered as a major, even if it was a minor. As they said, لا صغيرة لا كبيرة مع الاستغفار ولا صغيرة مع الإصرار. Look at this word, very nice word. لا صغيرة لا كبيرة مع الاستغفار ولا ها ولا صغيرة مع الإصرار. What does this mean? لا كبيرة مع الاستغفار. That will be, it will not be considered as a major if the person keeping what? Seeking forgiveness. مع الاستغفار. As long as you are seeking forgiveness, then this will not be counted as a major. ولا كبيرة ولا صغيرة مع الاستغفار. And also minor if you are insisting and persisting and you are continue doing this, this will not be considered as what? As a minor. In fact, it will be as as a major. طيب. And then the Shaykh said, the author, which is of the Riyadh al-Salihin, said, there are three conditions. This is what I explained to you. But here the Shaykh bin Uthaymeen, he said, but by studying, analyzing all that literature of the ulama, we found it five, not three. Okay, well, Shaykh Uthaymeen, where did you bring this five from? Now we'll talk about it. He said, the first condition, look, the first condition, al-ikhlasu lillah. Subhanallah. First thing is the sincerity, that when you repent sincerely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not to please your dad, your mom, you're afraid of the somebody will, or to show other people that you are getting back to the right path, no. So, بأن يكون قصد الإنسان وجه الله وأن يتوب الله عليه. All what he care is to repent to Allah Azza wa Jal alone sincerely from his heart and hope that Allah will forgive him. And doesn't, يعني, he doesn't mean or doing this just to for the show off or to get close to the people or to pay away or to push away any harm that it could happen to him because of doing this sin. Yeah, some people they say we are repent, no, and in their heart they are not repentant. The police will catch a man, who's smuggling drugs, for example. Say, oh, astaghfirullah, I repent to Allah. Okay, and when they leave him, and there's no police and no eyes looking at him, will come back again, deceiving. He's deceiving himself. He thinks that deceiving Allah or the believers. So the Shaykh, this is why the Shaykh said, it should be emphasized from the beginning that the first condition is what? Sincerity. Right. The second one is an-nadam, which is, as we said, to regret what he did. Because when he truly, يعني, sincere to repent, then he will feel, you know, grief that why he did it. He blames himself all the time. You know the Muslim, you know, when he go through any sin, commit any sin, he may not sleep. He think day and night, wow, did Allah forgive me for this or not? He may cry. As some of the Salafi, it's mentioned in some narration, that look at the believer. The believer, when he look at the sin that he committed, he feel about it like that he is seeing a mountain, a huge mountain up over his head, that this mountain may fall on him at any minute, at any second. Just imagine if you are walking and there's a mountain, what you will feel? And you know, at any minute this mountain will... This is the feeling of what? Of the believer. This, what is mountain? This is the sin that he committed. That he could be punished for this or committing this sin. طيب. The third one, which is to give up of the from this sin. And this is the most important thing because it is must, as the Shaykh said, tarku wajib, leave it. And he believes that it is must that he leave it. Like a person, he doesn't give zakat, then he should give it. Person is not good with his parents, then he should be nice to them. Person, he doesn't relate or visit his kinship, then he should stop that right, you know, away, and he go ask about them, visit them. This is because all these are haram. A person who are using riba, what should he do? He should stop. And say, well, I will, you know, I'll repent inshallah, but at the end of the year, you know, when they close all this account, then we see what's happened, and then inshallah, that's not right. He should repent right away. And also, he get rid of all the outcome of this ma'asiyah. Anything which come as a result of this sin, it should be what? Removed. A person who took money from somebody, he should return it to him. Okay,
he steal money and he doesn't know to whom this money is belong to. Then he should give it as sadaqah or give it to somebody else. A person who commit riba, this is many questions, many people ask me about this. They said, you know, we have to put our money in account. Yeah, we know this modern life. Yeah, all of us, they should put their money in account. In fact, if you don't have an account, you will not get your salary. Right or not? They transfer it. So what should I do? Alhamdulillah, if you are in a Muslim country, maybe there are some banks who are dealing in an Islamic way. But outside, there's an account that they force you to take what? To take interest. طيب. Should I leave this interest? I said, no, thank you. You can take this interest. Oh, they will be happy with this. Do you know why? They will take it, they will send it to missionary. They use it to change the religion of a Muslim. So you did double crime. You see, when you accept to take the interest, and when you left this interest for them. So what should I do? You said that it's a haram, I cannot take it. Yes, but in this case, you should take this interest. If you have no, as we said, this is as a last solution. If at the beginning, if there's any way that you have an account without riba, without interest, this is the thing that you should do, right? In case that there is none, and you have to have an account in the bank, then, okay. And then they force you to take an interest. They said, this account has come with interest. Yeah, it's must. This is our system. And you accept, because it's a matter of what? Necessity here, darura. طيب. Then, at the end of the year, you found in your account, mashallah, 500 riyals, or $500. I said, this is not my money, I only put 10,000. I said, yeah, this is your interest. This is your profit of your account. Then you should not leave it. You should take it, but it's not yours. You will not get reward to say that I'll give it as a charity, I'll get the reward of charity. No, you will not be getting the reward of charity. You will be getting the reward of getting rid of this money. How? You give it to some poor, some needy, and some ulama, they said you put it in a fixing toilet or something. There is no need for this. You can give it to anybody who's in need. But the important thing that it's in your attention, it's not as a sadaqah. No need. You just give it to anybody who need it. But not part of your zakah. Yeah. Huh? Don't count it as sadaqah. Na'am? The important thing that what? Huh? You get rid of this. Of this money, alhamdulillah.
Can we get rid of the money if we have to be like, if a business is in need, can we give the money to the business?
Business? What business?
If I own a business, can I give the money to the business because it's in need of the money? It's
like I don't know what do you mean by business. If it's your business, that means you are recycling the money. Right? If you mean that you are business, your business, the important thing, give it to somebody who needs it. You know, like this, what they call him, this. In the streets, they are living in the street. What they call them? Homeless people, people in need.
The order of the requirements should be joined. For example, in the business, they have SSS, yeah. Then you join this.
Yeah, they force you to take it. Okay, take it. Take it. As we said, don't leave it to them because their system. When you leave something and nobody needs, maybe they transfer it to charitable organization, mostly churches. Mostly. You see? So anyway, okay, brothers. طيب, leave the question at the end of the... طيب. This is an example. طيب. The Shaykh said, and then he should get rid of all these money, which is haram. If it was ghiba, what does it mean by ghiba? Backbiting. You talk about somebody ill. That's mean you said, so-and-so, he is like that, he is like this. and a word that hurt him, he doesn't like it, you cannot say it in front of him because you know that he will not like it. It's called ghiba. طيب, طيب. What should you do now? Now he has right on you. Do you know why? Because if he didn't repent from this, at the day of judgment, he will take from your account. You know, the account there, it's not dollars or riyal. It is hasanat. طيب. And one hasana, people are running, you know, begging for one hasana. The father, begging his son, my son, I raise you, I spend on you. Please, just one hasana. Sorry, dad, I think I need it. Subhanallah. La hawla la quwwata illa billah. This is a day of judgment. Everybody, caring, you know, afraid, caring about himself. So here, if you did something like this, backbiting somebody, then you should correct it. Either that you ask him to forgive you, but if he is rude, you know, if you say that, say, look, man, you know, the other day I was sitting with the people and said that you are ugly, you are like this, and he was may smash you in your face. What should you do then? You know, will start problems? No, they said in this situation that either that you talk and next, you know, you speak good about him to correct the image that you put in the mind of the people about this person. You got it? Right. But if you know that he's a nice person, and you come in general word, you say, you know, brothers, sometimes we talk, sometimes maybe I say something that you don't like. Will you forgive me, please? Please forgive me. Maybe I say something that you don't like. General. Okay. So the Muslim is very wise. The important thing that you should get rid by giving this person his right and correct his image if it was طيب. طيب. The Shaykh said, Subhanallah, and now if you look at the life of some people, many people, they said, oh, Shaykh, this is the time of troubles. Everybody using riba. Everybody, yeah, influenced by riba. Allah, yes, this is very, very mushkila. And he's dealing with riba. He didn't take any action to get rid of the riba. And then he just blamed the society, the community, time, just for his problem. Naam? طيب. The Shaykh mentioned the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, كل أمتي معافى إلا المجاهرين. So here the Shaykh, he moved to another point. Now, if a person did something wrong and he wants to repent, does he need to go to the judge or go in front of the people and say, hey, people, you are my friend, you know, you don't know that I was drink, you know, heavy drunker before, I used to do this and this. No, this is considered what? Mujahara. Consider mujahara. You should not tell people. Allah Azza wa Jal cover you with his sitter. You should not uncover yourself. Even the person, if you commit a sin, he should not, I mean, it's not must that he go to the court or to the judge to tell him that I did this and this and this. And if you look in the seerah of the Prophet ﷺ, when Ma'iz, there's one of the Sahaba who came to me, said, O Prophet of Allah, clean me. Cleanse me. What you did? I committed zina. The Prophet ﷺ turned his face to the other side. He doesn't want to hear from him. And then he come to him, the other side. O Prophet of Allah, O Messenger of Allah, please clean me. And the Prophet ﷺ, he know that he is sound mind, and ask me, is there any problem with the mind of this man? He gave him chance. But he insisted. So when he insisted, na'am, then there's no way but to apply the law, the rules. So from this we know that the person, he commit any sin, it's very important for the Muslim to not show his sins to other. We don't mean that, yeah, you can do it secretly. No. Allah Azza wa Jal, يعلم السر وأخفى. He knows what the secret and what's beyond the secret. Doesn't, you know, subhanAllah, everything is visible for Allah Azza wa Jal. He knows what's your own heart. He knows what the sin that you commit before you commit it. And what was your intention. But what does it mean? You know, the Muslim, we are a human being. If in any situation that you commit a sin and nobody see it, it's not right to go and tell others. Right? Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كل أمتي معافى إلا المجاهرين. Every one of my ummah, na'am, will be good. Tayyib, will not be in trouble, will not be in problem. Except those who mujahareen. Those who what? Tell it in public. In public, that means tell everybody about it. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained what does it mean, al-mujahareen. He said, أن يعمل الرجل بالليل عملا ثم يصبح وقد ستره الله فيقول يا فلان عملت البارحة كذا وكذا. Look, the explanation is said, أن يعمل الرجل بالليل عملا. A man, he may do something at night time. ثم يصبح. And then the following day, the morning, وقد ستره الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala covered him. Nobody knows about what he did. And then he go and said, hey, so and so, hey, my friend, my buddy, you know what I did last night? So he talk about what? Salam. He said, last night I did this and I did that and I did that. And this is what some people are doing, especially young people. They think, you know, it's nice talk. Oh, last night I was and I found and I see, you know, and we spent nice time and telling people he's proud of what he did. Right? Some people even lie to show their friends that they are tough. Yeah, we can do this, we can do it, you know. Subhanallah. So this is what the Prophet said. So the one who do this, he will not be forgiven. He's not, he's in bad shape. Why? Because Allah covered him. بَاتَ رَبُّهُ يَسْتُرُهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the whole night, and he's covering him. Nobody is seeing them. And Allah Azza wa Jal able to uncover him at that time, right or not? But it is the mercy of Allah, the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, blessing of Allah Azza wa Jal, that he was covered with the sitr of Allah. And then he go and uncover the cover that Allah Azza wa Jal, they say that he put on him. Some ulama said, إِذَا فَعَلَ الْإِنسَانُ ذَنْبًا فِيهِ حَدٍ فَلَا بَأْسَ أَنْ يَذْهَبْ. يعني some scholars, they said, well, if the ithm or the sin, there is حد من الحدود, like drinking or committing zina, then it is, they said, then it's okay to go to the judge or to the ruler to tell them. But the sheikh said, وَمَعَ ذَلِكَ فَالْأَفْضَلْ أن يستر نفسه. It is better, huh? That he should what? Cover himself. There's no need to go and tell about this. طيب. That's mean, the sheikh said, that's mean, if he want to go, it's okay. We don't say, don't go, it is haram. It's okay. But what's the better? Huh? Not to go. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you. طيب. The Shaykh gave an example. If a person, he committed zina, the Shaykh said, Usturu ala nafsik. Then cover yourself. No need to go and tell about it. طيب. As long as you repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. Some people say, why? Look at the Sahaba. The Sahabi, to see, he went and he, you see the Sahaba, they have, subhanallah, strong faith. They afraid. We don't say that we are not afraid, but you know, to the point that they are willing to sacrifice just to be clear from their sin. But it's not must. Allah Azza wa Jalla is very merciful. Naam, Allah Rahim subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. But if the, also the, we repeat here, if the the sin or that the person commit is related to somebody else, like taking money from somebody, then he should give it back to him. طيب, this man that you took his money passed away, died. What should he do? Give it to his heirs. To his heirs, those who inherit him. طيب, if you don't know where is he, long time, 30 years ago, you were in one town and you took the money of man, you know him, but you don't know where is he now. You know, people are moving. You know. So what should you do? Then you give it as a sadaqah, huh? In his behalf. In his behalf. So in this you get rid. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows and give it to him. طيب. The Shaykh said, if a person that you smash his face or you beat him, then you go and ask him to forgive you, even if he said, I will do the same thing for you. You know, but most people, generally speaking, most people, when you come to him and tell him that, well, I did this wrong to you, what do you expect? People will say, okay, as long as you know this, so I forgive you. This is the way that most people are doing. But the Prophet, Allah Azza wa Jal said, وَجَزَاءُ سَيِّئَةٍ سَيِّئَةٍ مِثْلَا فَمَنْ اَعْتَدَى عَلَيْكُمْ فَاَعْتَدُوا عَلَيْهِ بِمِثْلِ مَا اَعْتَدَى عَلَيْكُمْ. Anyone who commit اعتداء, you know, or insult or assault against you, then if you did or retain the same, then this is fair. This is fair. The fourth, أن يكون الحق غيبة, يعني أنك تكلمت به في غيبته وقدحت فيه عند الناس. طيب, now this is for situation. A person, as we said, if he backbite. The ulama have different view. Some they said you should go and tell him and please forgive me. Others said don't go. Don't go. And there's more detail. So he said, if he knew about this, that means the other person, he was informed about what you said about him, then you should what do? Huh? You should go and ask him to excuse you. Otherwise, you just, as we mentioned before, you mention him in a good manner, the same way that you mention him in a good way. The fourth condition is al-azmu ala alla ta'ud. As we said, determination, planning, that you never go back and commit the same sin. طيب, if somebody said, yeah, well, I get tired. Every time I said, oh Allah, I will not do this and ask forgiveness, but I can't. What should I do? My dear brother, there are some people, close the door. Close the door, please. Okay, 40? Okay, so we'll close with this. We'll close with this. So we'll talk about this because it has more detail, inshallah. Inshallah, we'll talk about it next week. But in general, you know, the last point that I said, if the person commit a sin, especially those who are, what they call them, like people who are drinking alcohol, addicted. So he say, okay, and maybe he take all these bottles and throw it away. Huh? Even he bought it and paid money for it. And he was sincere to repent. But after week, 2-3 weeks, and then he retained. Then also he make what? Tawbah again. The important thing that he should always seek tawbah. Even if it was repeated, no problem. As long as when you made your tawbah, you did it sincerely from your heart, determined not to do it again, then you are sincere, you are truthful. Naam? So if it was happened again, then also you go and seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll stop here, inshallah. We'll continue, inshallah, next week.